But perhaps there's no better way to illustrate this key issue than to invoke the patron saint, pardon the expression, of the humanist movement, Thomas Jefferson, and his famous phrase, the wall of separation between church and state. These words, you may be surprised to know, appear nowhere in either the Constitution or the Bill of Rights. Our third president penned them on New Year's Day, 1802, in a letter to some Christians who were concerned about their freedom to practice their Baptist faith in a largely non-Baptist state, Connecticut. Jefferson, who admittedly was far from being a true Christian, at least at this stage in his life, nevertheless meant only to assure them that the government had absolutely no right to regulate their system of worship. Men are free to practice their religion, or lack thereof, with impunity from the state. That he didn't mean the opposite, that the state needed to wall itself off from Christianity, as the ACLU and others like to cram down our throats, can be seen in one simple and oft-neglected fact of history. 2 days after writing those words, Jefferson attended church services held, in of all places, the House of Representatives. That government buildings were used to promote the Christian religion was not at all unusual. As the Library of Congress, in an exhibit entitled Religion and the Founding of America, recently noted, it's no exaggeration to say that on Sundays in Washington, during the administrations of Thomas Jefferson and of James Madison, the state became the church. The gospel was also preached in the Supreme Court chambers.